Here's how to install and configure a Serial Interface plugin. Go to the bottom right and select Plugin Manager. From here, select Interface Plugins. From the list of available plugins, select the one that you wish to install. I will be using the Serial Interface plugin. I'm going to click Install and select Yes. This will take you back to the home screen. Go to the drop-down menu and select Interface Setup. From here, you can use the drop-down menu to select the interface plugin that you are using. I will be using the Serial Interface plugin. Now we can start to configure. The COM port is the port your interface is plugged into. I'm going to use COM port 1. Bitrate is the speed that your interface runs at. For this example, I will be using the most common value, 115200. Next, you will choose the number of data bits in each character. I'm going to be using 8. Select a parity bit. This is a method of detecting error in data transmission and is frequently set to none. Stop bits are the number of bits that allow the hardware to detect the end of a character. I will be using 1. The bit range settings are the number of bits the interface is expecting when setting a new target. I will be using 8, but your settings depend on the hardware you're using and the range that it can support. Next, the output type setting is how the values are sent. You can choose to have them either sent as binary, decimal, or a set of hex values. The startup and shutdown outputs are for commands needed before interface output begins and after interface output shuts down. The slow startup and parking locations are built into version 3, so those no longer need to be configured in these sections. Here's where you'll enter your formatted output. Here I'm going to be using Axis 1A and Axis 2A. I will also be using an output rate of 10. Now that my configurations for this interface are complete, I'm going to click Save. After saving your configurations, test your settings to make sure that your actuators move as expected before moving on. Make sure to save before testing your settings, otherwise it will not work properly. You can test this by adjusting the sliders and changing the values. To return to interface setup, select Stop Testing. In the interface setup, in the top left area, there is a reset button. By clicking this, you will reset your current settings and start from scratch. You will also notice at the top of your screen, you have a total of 6 interfaces that you can configure. Every interface is different, so the values that you use will most likely differ from the video. Now let's look at how you can find out more information about your plugin and how to uninstall it. If you want to find more information about the plugin that you have installed, go to the Interface Plugin section within the Plugin Manager and hover over the plugin of your choice. You will notice an icon in the top left corner of the plugin banner. By clicking this, it will take you to the homepage of that plugin on the SimTools website. If you are uninstalling a plugin and the banner has a red X in the top right corner, that means that your plugin is assigned somewhere. Here's how to unassign it. To unassign a plugin, use the drop-down menu and deselect the plugin that you wish to uninstall. After unassigning your plugin, you will notice that the red X has turned into a trash can. If you wish to uninstall your plugin, you may now click the trash can and select Yes.